Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about polynomials and vocabulary, really, that's associated with polynomials. Polynomials are just the sum of one or more terms that are raised to natural powers. So we don't have any negative powers and we don't see division in those polynomial terms. Monomial means one term. An example of monomials, I've got four different examples. Notice there's several factors in this, but there's no addition and subtraction. So polynomials, you're adding these terms together. And sometimes you add a negative term, it looks like subtraction, but we can basically say they're all addition. So monomials have one term. Note the prefix mono. And then binomials have two terms. So in these terms, you can have an addition in between, or you can have a subtraction, but we could definitely rewrite this binomial as plus negative 5x, right? And so because we can rewrite subtraction to addition, we could say yes, a subtraction is serves for polynomials. And this is also. So notice there's no negative terms or half power terms. They're all natural numbers, which are the numbers that we count with, are what makes polynomials. And so trinomials have three terms, and here's an example of trinomials. There's three, they're separated by addition and subtraction, you can see in there. And so we have binomial, the prefix was bi, trinomial, the prefix was tri. And these are all polynomials, all these terms that I've listed. But if you have more than three terms, you just call them polynomials. But this is a polynomial. We just give it specific terms for the one, two, or three, because we use those so much, we've given them specific terms. But polynomials in general could have one term or 85 terms, doesn't matter. Every term in a polynomial has a coefficient, and the coefficient is the number multiplying the variable. So if you take a look up here, you can see obviously the coefficient of this term is 5. But this term also has a coefficient, which is just negative 6. And that's because we can really think of negative 6 as a variable to the zero power. Remember, anything to the zero power is 1. It's an imaginary x to the zero power. So the coefficient is negative 6 there. The coefficient of this term, even though we don't see a number, is negative 1, because if I have a negative a, that's really like a negative 1. And the coefficient of this term would be 1/2. The coefficient of this term is 3. This term is 4. So even a constant term has a coefficient. This is negative 1 and this is negative 5. Notice if I saw it up here, I'd have to realize that negative is part of that coefficient. This has got a positive 1 coefficient and this one has a negative 1 coefficient. And so you can go through and name the coefficient of all these terms. The coefficient of this term right here is negative 3 because it's got that negative. The degree is the power of the variable. So I can go back to all these and I could say this is a second degree term. This is a first degree term because if I just see x, I have to remember that's really x to the first power, right? And this is a zero degree term because any constant has an imaginary zero power variable next to it. So that's a zero degree term. Fifth degree term, seventh degree term, second degree term, third degree, second degree, first degree. So you're just looking at the power. Third degree, fifth degree. It's the power of the variable. That's the degree of the term. Now, if you have something like this where you have two terms, I don't think this comes up in your homework, but you would add those together. So it'd be a fifth degree term because 3 plus 2 is 5. There's 5 powers in there all together. And we can say the degree of the polynomial is the degree of the highest term. So this is a fifth degree term, a seventh degree term, and a second degree term. But if I said, what's the degree of this polynomial? It would be 7 because we look at the highest power of any single term. So that's a seventh degree polynomial. This is a third degree polynomial. And finally, another vocabulary is descending order, and that's writing a polynomial from the highest degree to the lowest degree. So some of these I automatically typically do. I had to force myself to not do it. But like this is second degree, I mean third degree, second degree, first degree. That is in descending order. This one's not in descending order. What would be the first term if it was in descending order? Well, the first term would be negative 3p to the 7th. Notice that whatever signs in front of that comes along with it. And then positive p to the 5th, and finally p squared. And that first term, that highest degree term, that's the degree of the polynomial, and it's called the lead term. So our lead term is negative 3p to the 7th. That's our highest power term, and that sets the power for the whole polynomial. This one is in descending order. This one's not. I could rewrite that as negative y to the 5th plus y to the 3rd. That would be descending order, highest power down to lowest power. Notice that the negative came along with that. I have to always bring along the sign that goes with it. Okay, so what we're going to do just to wind this video up is take a polynomial and write down what the coefficient of each term is, what the degree of each term is, and then finally write it in descending order. The coefficients from left to right, the first one, the coefficient is negative 5. This term, it's a constant, but constants have coefficients. There's a negative in front of it, so it's negative 1/2. This one is positive 6. This one is negative 7. And the last one is positive 5. Those are the coefficients of the terms in the order that they were given. The degree is the power of the variable. This has a power of 1, even though we didn't see it originally. This one has no variable, so it's a power of 0. This one has a power of 3, this one has a power of 2, and this has a power of 5. And now if I wanted to rewrite that in descending order, I want to make sure as I put those in descending order that I have pluses or minus in between, as because it's a polynomial is either added or subtracted each of those terms. I wasn't trying to write a polynomial here, so I didn't put pluses or minus necessarily, but I will when I'm rewriting the polynomial. The highest power in here is my last term, which is 5x to the 5th. And that was a plus in front of it, so I don't have to worry about that. Next highest power is going to be the third power term. Then my second power, notice that minus, that has to come along. 5, 3, 2, I didn't have a 4, no. And then 1, negative 5x. I don't need to write that first power. And then finally, I have the minus 1/2. This is 5th degree, 3rd degree, 2nd degree, 1st degree, 0 degree. So that's descending order. This is a 5th degree polynomial, because the highest power in there is the 5th power. And that lead term would be 5x to the 5th. Okay, have a great day. We'll see you next time.